Hotep, Senu, Hena, Senut. Iti, En, Sebait, Medunecher. Ren, I, Shaka, Ndugu, Kemet. Today we're looking at the word Meri, which stands for beloved. The first glyph, reference U6, stands for Mer. Then you have the two plant reed, reference M17. When you have only one, it is transliterated with the letter I. But when you have two, it is transliterated with the letter Y. However, it is still pronounced the same. It's the sound E. This artifact is located in the Louvre Museum, reference B74-B75, dated between 1898 BCE, before the Common Era. Meri is translated as beloved. In red, you have the transliteration. In black, the pronunciation. And in green, the translation. Besides the word Meri written there, we can see some other symbols that we have addressed before. And we will go into more details about them later on. In the middle, the triangle is a stylized cone of bread. It stands for D, which means to give or being given. Then, I'm sure that all of you have recognized the Ankh. The next symbol is Was, which stands for power. The only thing that is not appearing clearly is the bottom of the scepter. Then you have the solar disk, Ra, and then this is the symbol Mi, transliterated with the letter M and the letter I, which means like. So, may he have life, or may he be given life, or giving life, power, like Ra. I did not want to make this video too long, but following Mira, you have Jet, which means eternally or forever. Those are sayings that we find very regularly in the Kemetic writings. So make sure that you put some thumbs up to this video, that you subscribe to my account, which is youtube.com/maatforever. If you want to see a hieroglyphic sign list, the address is on the top right corner, afrostudy.com/gardener. Dua for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy, and I will definitely holler back at you later. Hotel.